Oh, good morning. Welcome back to the Ohio Farm. It's the end of January. We're over at the General Mill yesterday, kind of monitoring the production of the canola oil. Man, it was pumping the stuff out. Wow, air ball did go in. Sold bale. Gonna have to go check the feeding place here. We stayed over there putting pallets away in the warehouse till probably a little before 5 o'clock. And then I actually turned the production off because I was having a tough time keeping up with it. Oh, we don't have a full one yet. Yeah. It was something. Why don't we go take care of that bale, I guess. We can talk as we go. We'll swing by. Check it out. I guess we could turn it back on again. We're gonna take the weed over today. We'll keep using Bill's pace setter, since he was kind enough to let us use it. But yeah, the production was, it was really pumping the stuff out. About 5 o'clock, a little before five, I turned it off, put the last few pallets into the warehouse. Headed over to the west place to put things away, and it started snowing. It snowed for a little bit. Not quite sure. It got dark. I went in, but nothing accumulated. So not too bad, I guess. Hesitant to turn the production back on. It was just, man, it hurt really. So, just hit Gene's mailbox there. That wouldn't be good. He wouldn't like that, I don't think. Not one bit. Miss out on the revenue over here, so we'll get it on the mail right away. Ooh, you're like all jammed in here. Oh, yeah, it's all right. Here to the mill. I'll show you what I was talking about. And we'll go empty the grain bin at the home place and get the weed out of there. Bring it over here and get that started. Start producing some flour. A bit of canola in, and the pallets are like 1,000. I think we're gonna end up with like 100 pallets of canola oil. That's kind of one reason I turned it off. There is a pallet in it. I can't remember what it is. there's none sitting there, it's because I put them all into the warehouse here. Dark, so I started stacking them over here, and I realized, man, if I get like 100 of these, I'm gonna fill this whole warehouse up. So then I started double stacking them, but that was a little too heavy to put two up that high. So then when I got over here, I just put a single one up there. So what do we got here? That's 7, and then that would be double that, so that's 14. 7 and 14 is 21, and then here's another 12, 13, so 34, and then another 9, 6. And another 6, 40. I got 40 pallets of canola oil in here right now. Forklift's working great. And then over here, we still have 64,000 liters in here. Where's the canola oil? There we go. So about 950 makes 760. So that's probably another 50 pallets worth right there. And how much is currently stored? Right there, 478. So it's gonna start spitting out the pallets again here pretty soon. Thank you. shoot, since I got this on, I might as well just use it on the trailer. Okay. That ought to work. into it, ain't I? This over to the old General Mill, get it chugging away on the flour as well. Thank you. interested to see how many canola pellets have spawned in the time we've been away. I guess probably about 4 to 6. I mean, it really pumps them out. Will give us 800 flour and 200 chaff. So it should just be one more load, and I think that'll be all the wheat that we have. So, let's see. Best way I've found to get out of here is to kind of... back straight up. And then swing out and around. So I'll go get the rest of the wheat. Put it in the back one here first. That's not pleasant to look at. That'll work. Is that gonna get all the rest of it out of there? I hope so. I don't think it will though. It's 21,000. It's just gonna be just a little left. I got an idea what we can do with that. Maybe. How much is left? $1,240 liters, that's not much at all. Alright, let's run this out there. So, for all intents and purposes, the remainder of our week on the way to the general mill. We'll start making the flour too. I'm not sure. I think I need to be concerned about how many pallets I'm creating, so I might turn off the oil for a while. After I put some of them in the warehouse. I believe there's a pallet limit, just like the, I know there's a pallet limit, just like the mail limit. I ran into it on Elm Creek when I owned the sugar mill and a flour mill, and I was producing a lot of pallets. Dairy producing pallets, we've got maple syrup producing pallets, we've got honey or beehives producing pallets, we've got the garden not producing pallets right now, but, and then we've got the general mill, so we've got a lot of pallets that can be produced. I need to manage how much the general mill is pumping out. Because then we'll also need pallets of garden substrate, or fertilizer, or seeds, and stuff. So, silage additive for seed treatment. To the mill, but the ground was slightly sloped and it didn't seem to want to put one in. I didn't work real hard to try and figure it out. Once I got this to work, I was happy with it. But I tried to drive a truck through it. Because it's not easy or forgiving. Careful, it's all right. Oh my God, look at all the flour. There's another pallet waiting to spawn, and almost one right after that too. Maybe we'll get those two done and then call it. Let's see, that? Get the rest of the flour out. Or get the rest of the meat out. How quickly is it pumping out flour? Come over here, flour. So there's couple, 2,000 meter pounds or 1,000 meter pounds? I don't even know. Let's see. They're 1,000. So that means it's going to be a lot of those too. This is problematic. All these pallets. Got a little bump there. I gotta be careful of that. Well, the flour I'll only be able to take one at a time. There's no way I'm gonna be able to stack the flour in there too big of pallets. Spawn there. Probably have, ooh, both flowers. Okay. This is kind of tight quarters for this. Not easy to do this. Given the number of pallets that we have, I can see the attraction of one of the, like the store pallet and bale storage type buildings when you're dealing with this much. I mean, it's a little bit of finessing and stuff. I don't mind it so much, but when I have other things to do, it's probably not going to be as novel anymore. Right now it's new and novel, and it's like, oh, this is great. It's sort of like small square bales. And it's like, oh, they're not so bad. Until you got 100 of them, you got to manhandle. Then all of a sudden, it's not so much fun. So you start saying, maybe an auto load bale trailer wouldn't be such a bad thing. We'll just say we talked to the high school football coach, and he had team practice, had the players come out, toss hay bales around. What? What was that? What's that? I thought... crazy, that's the chaff. I thought the chaff would be over here. Chaff. What are my options? Selling, distributing, storing. distributing. Okay, hang on. Let's check the fermenting silo. It's not going up. That's interesting. I don't know. Something when it get this one put, let's pull the truck up underneath that kind of the output and see if that's what I thought was gonna happen. I'm disappointed that it's making crates of chaff. Not going to be so good. Because of the tight area we're dealing with, it's just, there's too much finessing. Yeah, I'll get better at it, I suppose, but... Take a look at this. Takes to get into reverse high gear. Just the regular, oh, you can treat this like a silo. Well, that's good to know. But, okay. But the chaff's gonna come out here in crates like this. Look at it crank. Crazy. So we're gonna have to... Gonna have to load the chaff into the silage boss somehow. Okay, well, I finished lunch. Came back over here after handling some pallets for a while, but man, I got tired of it. What did I get myself into? This honey pallet hasn't even completed itself yet in the amount of time it took it to spawn dozens and dozens of pallets. It's crazy. All right. Wow. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go grab that half pipe trailer. We'll get the wheel loader. We're going to take a load of stones over and see if we can kick that lime production over there into gear. Turning the wrong way. It's about where I want it for now. I would like to put it back there, but that's wishful thinking, I think, at this point. Bear with me for a minute or two. It just gets going. I cannot. I can't moderate the accelerator slowly enough. Give it a little and then it starts being too much. Very quickly becomes too much. Right there. That's enough time. Here and grab the half pipe trailer. I haven't really been over here yet today, have I? So I got this big pile of stones that we've been working on for quite a while now. Years we've been building up this pile of stones. So I'm gonna go grab the wheel loader and we'll fill that up and we'll take it over to the crusher that we have at the mill, and it makes limestone. We got snow in the forecast. I wonder when that's supposed to come. Just do one load of this. We could do more, but try and keep the episode moving. Do a few different things. Try to. Good work. Oh boy, that's too heavy. Way too heavy. Okay, so how do I... Okay, I think about 2,500 liters I can lift. Oh man, sold the bale again? You know what that means? We gotta go back over to the... Stones are so heavy. That 2683. What did we have last time? I don't know. One second, sir. Ooh, I might be able to... No. But for a second, I might be able to lift that. No. Let's try about 35. It's a little too heavy. But if we're careful, I think we can get it. Alright. One more partial bucket, and that should be enough. Probably a good idea to do it not on land that's yours, so that way once it's full it doesn't like dump onto the ground. Okay. I guess I'll go by jeans, go to the container field so I can put the bale in, and then we'll continue on over to the mill. Still got four. Four pallets of flour to put away. Oh, on the chaff. It is starting to distribute. I guess it distributes on the hour. It's not something I knew because I've never really done the distributing before. So I got those two pallets there, and then the rest of it did start distributing over to the stave silo. Turn this on. And let that run for a little bit. We're running low on time. One more thing I want to do. Okay, it's 2 o'clock in the afternoon. I'm over here at Hogs. Something came up used. So here it is, a TLX Phoenix. So I've got an idea of what I can do with this. Okay, well, I can't help myself. Down to just over $30,000 Now, I'm not sure everybody will agree with what I did here, but I got myself a straight truck with a flatbed on the back. I don't know. What it did. Can't help myself sometimes. I think it'll come in handy for moving the pallets from the mill around. This is actually a pallet auto load version. This might prevent me from having to move all those pallets into the warehouse all the time. Don't know. Tell me what you think down in the comment section. But shade side, not so good. I like it. Dark. Thanks for joining me here at the Ohio farm. Hope you enjoyed it. If you did, hit that like button. If you don't subscribe yet, why not? It don't cost nothing. We'll see you next time.